Namaskaram girls,
the yesterday's class, the previous video we have started learning
chapter 5
monetary economics. In that chapter we have learned the definitions of two economists, famous economists. One is Walker, the another one is Crowther. What is the definition of Walker? Money is what money does. And Crowther, money is nothing but it is generally acceptable and at the same time it acts as a medium of exchange and the store of value. And then we studied about the barter system. What do you mean by barter system? Goods and services exchanged for goods and services, or goods exchanged for goods, is called barter system. And they face so many difficulties in the barter system. So after that they invented the form of money. The first one is metal standard, that is copper and iron are used as metals, and the value of metals, so in the barter system we study the commodity money also, commodity goods also. And then metal standard, the metals are used as a common product for exchanging the goods and services. And then in the metal standard we study the gold standard and also the silver standard, which have the same weight. The measure of the the weight of the gold and the value of the gold, they convert into the value of the goods they buy, isn't it? So the value of the weight and the value of the particular metal, they exchange for the value of the goods. And then the paper currency, the invention of the paper currency, and the RBI is the sole authority of issuing the paper currency, isn't it? In India, Central Bank or Reserve Bank of India is the sole authority to issue the paper notes, currency notes. And the elimination of plastic money, that is credit card, debit card, smart cards and other things. So those are all called plastic money. Why they invented the plastic money? It is easy to carry. To avoid carrying the cash, we can use the plastic money. And then now the digital currency, that is cryptocurrency, which is consists of bitcoins and other things. So the evaluation of money we learn. So like fire and wheel, money is also considered to be one of the best invention of the mankind. And today we are going to learn the functions of money. What are the functions of money? Money has four functions: primary, secondary, other and contingent functions. The first one is primary function. Money has two primary functions. One is medium of exchange, the other one is measure of value. Already I told you, money acts as a medium of exchange, isn't it? We use money to buy goods and other things. And it is also considered to be one of the basic function of the money, because it is generally acceptable, as Crowther said, it is generally acceptable by all the people in the world. So it has a general acceptability, and it is also the exchange or also takes place in the form of money. So money acts as a medium of exchange. Now the use of money, the transaction has been divided into two parts, isn't it? First one, money is obtained through sales and service. This is known as sale. So while we talk about the medium of exchange, there are two type of exchange. One is sale, the other one is purchase, isn't it? In this two form, money is exchanged from one person to another person. While we are selling goods and services, in turn we are getting the money. And in other hand, while we are purchasing the goods and services, we have to pay the money. So the payment of money or the transaction of money has been divided into two parts: One is sale, the another one is purchase. So in the modern system, it is also considered as the intermediary in sales and purchases. So in the medium of exchange, money acts as a medium of exchange. It is considered to be one of the basic function of the money. And through sale and purchase, the money transaction of money has been divided into two parts. One is sale, the other one is purchase. When we are selling goods, in turn we are getting money. While we are purchasing goods, we are giving money. So in both the transaction, the money is exchanged. So this is medium of exchange. The second primary function is, it is the measure of value. Money acts as a measure of value. It is considered to be the second important function. That is, when we talk about the value of the goods and other things, we used to say in the form of price. So the price of all goods and services are expressed in the terms of money. Usually we used to say that, isn't it? ஒரு பொருளுக்கான விலையவோ மதிப்பையோ தீர்மானிக்கணும்னா பணத்தின் மூலமா தான் அதை என்ன செய்வோம், தீர்மானம் பண்ணுவோம். சோ த பிரைஸ் ஆஃப் ஆல் த குட்ஸ் அண்ட் சர்வீசஸ் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் இன் த டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் மணி. சோ இட் இஸ் கன்சிடர்ட் டு பி த கலெக்டிவ் மெஷர் ஆஃப் வேல்யூ. அண்ட் ஆல்சோ இட் இஸ் ஈஸியர் டு டிட்டர்மைன் த ரேட் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் பிட்வீன் த வேரியஸ் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் குட்ஸ் இன் த கம்யூனிட்டி. சோ ஒரே கம்யூனிட்டியில வி ஹவ் டிஃபரெண்ட் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் குட்ஸ். But it is the money is a common thing which measures the value of different commodities. So it acts as a measure of value. These are the two things. This is the basic function and this is the second most important function of our money. These two functions are called primary function. And secondary function, money acts as a store of value and it is the standard of deferred payments. For example, first one, money acts as a store of value. Savings, isn't it? Storage means savings. Savings in done in terms of commodities were not permanent, isn't it? But with the invention of money, it is the difficulty has now disappeared and savings are now done in terms of money. Illaya, earlier period la they used to store their valuable goods in the form of commodities, things. பழைய பாட்டி தாத்தா நம்ம வீட்டெல்லாம் இருக்காங்கன்னா பித்தளை பாத்திரம், செம்பு பாத்திரம், வெள்ளி பாத்திரம் சொல்லி ஸ்டோர் பண்ணி வைப்பாங்க. கமாடிட்டிஸ் ஆர் கன்சிடர்ட் வேல்யூபிள் திங்ஸ் இன் தோஸ் டேஸ். சோ தே ஸ்டோர் கமாடிட்டிஸ். பட் நவ் இட் ஹஸ் பீன் சேஞ்ச். மணி இஸ் வெரி ஈஸி திங் விச் கேன் பி ஸ்டோர்ட் ஈஸிலி அண்ட் இட் டசன்ட் ஸ்டோர் மச் பிளேஸ். இல்லையா, பேங்க் நீ வந்து இப்ப பணமா பெரிய பெரிய பாத்திரங்களா வீட்டுல ஸ்டோர் பண்ணி வைக்கிறது போல we can convert into money and we can deposit in the bank. So now it acts as a store of value and it is also serves as the excellent store of wealth. Illaya, in the form of wealth panatha vandu chethu vekkum and it is also easily converted into other marketable asset. இப்படி பணத்தை நிறைய சேர்த்து வச்சுன்னா ஒரு 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 லிமிட்டுக்கு அப்புறம் யூ கேன் கன்வெர்ட் இன் டு லேண்ட், மிஷினரிஸ், ஹவுஸ், பில்டிங்ஸ். அந்த மாதிரி நீ என்ன செஞ்சுக்கலாம், அதை ஈஸியா அந்த பணத்தை வச்சு நீ வாங்கிக்கலாம். ஸோ இட் கேன் பி ஈஸிலி கன்வெர்டபிள் இன் டு அசட். அதை வெல்தா நீ வச்சிருக்கிற. இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஸ்டோரிங் த மணி இன் த பேங்க் அட் அ பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டைம் யூ கேன் சேஞ்ச் இட் இன் டு கன்வெர்ட் இன் டு யுவர் அசட். வெல்தா நீ மாத்திக்கலாம், மூவபிளாவோ இம்மூவபிள் அசட்டாவோ உன்னால என்ன செஞ்சுக்க முடியும், ஈஸியா மாட்டிக்க முடியும். ஸோ இட் இஸ் கன்சிடர்ட் வித் அ ஸ்டோர் ஆஃப் வேல்யூ. அண்ட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் டெஃபர்ட் பேமெண்ட். Borrowing and lending were difficulties in the barter system, illaya. So in those days the people, they cannot borrow or lend money, lend the things and goods and services to other people. So it was very difficult to borrow or lend things in the barter system. But nowadays it is very easy, isn't it? Bank is also giving the credit and we are getting loans, we are borrowing loans and we are lending loans. So everything is done by money. So money is act as a standard of deferred payment. That is for borrowing and lending purpose. We are using in the terms of money only. And it is act as a standard of deferred payments. And the third one is money is a means of transferring of purchasing power. Transferring purchasing power. That's the word known as transferring purchasing power. Money act as a medium of transferring purchasing power. What do you mean by that? The field of exchange. It is also went on extending with the growing economic development. So, the exchange of goods is now extended to distant land also. That means export and import. That is the distant land. So, we are now extending our sale or purchase from faraway places and also to faraway places. That means now the trade has been increased. So money is also act as a transferring the purchasing power. What do you mean by purchasing power? What we can buy with the help of that particular amount of money is called purchasing power. Already I have taught you in the third lesson. Purchasing power is nothing but the previous 11th standard also you have studied. What do you mean by purchasing power? How much we can get with the help of that money is called purchasing power. So, now we are increasing or extending our purchasing power by buying the foreign goods, and also we are extending our purchasing power by selling our foreign goods. So, it is considered to be the secondary function of the money. And the other function, money helps to maintain the repayment capacity. Isn't it? I already told you it is acceptable by all the people in the world. So, for repaying our credit and other things, all the firm they have liquid cash for the repayment of their loans. So, they can ensure their repayment of their capacity only by in the terms of money. For example, if பக்கத்துல இதுலயே ஒரு நீ ஒரு பேங்க்ல போய் கடன் வாங்க போற ஒரு கிரெடிட் கேக்குற ஒரு லோன் கேட்க போறீங்க அப்படின்னா they will ask you that if you are an employee they will ask you the salary certificate of your institution. உனக்கு ஈஸியா புரியணுங்கிறதா இப்ப நான் சொல்றேன். இப்ப ஐ வாண்ட் டு பை அ லோன் ஃப்ரம் கனரா பேங்க் இல்லையா, நம்மளுடைய அக்கௌண்ட் எல்லாமே கனரா பேங்க் இருக்கு. இஃப் ஐ வாண்ட் டு கெட் அ லோன் ஃப்ரம் த கனரா பேங்க், what they will do, they will ask me the salary slip of mine. என்னுடைய salary slip கேட்பாங்க. என்னுடைய salary slip what they will give us, school எனக்கு வந்து எவ்வளவு salary they are providing, net salary எவ்வளவு, gross எவ்வளவு, எனக்கு எவ்வளவு PF கொடுக்கறாங்க. So all the details will be break up order, they will give you the salary slip. Based on the salary slip they will give me them. So, என்னுடைய repayment capacity, how they are measuring my repayment capacity by the terms of money, what I am earning. So, அதுதான் the third one. Other functions like it helps to maintain the repayment capacity. So, with the money which I earn every month, this is my repayment capacity. And also the banks, insurance companies and even government, they have to keep some liquid money to maintain the repayment capacity. And next one is general, it represents the generalized purchasing power that can be put into use in any uses. So it is not necessary that money should be only used for purchase but which has been served. So money, it was generally, it generalized by its purchasing power. General இந்த பொருள் தான் அதுதான் இதுதான்ங்கிறது கிடையாது. Generally, whatever we buy, whatever we are purchasing, it can be termed in the terms of money. Then it gives liquidity to the capital. That means it is the most liquid form. What do you mean by liquidity or liquid form? Which can be spent easily. Liquid form, we can be spent easily. For example, I have a lot of jewels with me, but I didn't have money with me. Can I buy a thing immediately which I need, which I require? No, it is not possible. But at the same time, if I have money with me, I can easily buy. So that is liquid form. Liquid form means easy to spend up. For example, if a check, the business people, they used to give bearer check.
வேற செக்லாம் ஈஸி டு லிக்விட் நீ பேங்க்க்கு போனாலே அதை என்ன செய்யலாம் ஈஸிலி என் கேஷ் பண்ணிக்கலாம் கேஷாக மாற்றிக்கலாம் ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி உள்ளதெல்லாம் தான் லிக்விட் ஃபார்ம் சொல்லுவோம் மணி இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் லிக்விட் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் வெல்த் ஈஸியாக ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ண முடியும் நம்ம நினைச்ச உடனே அதை என்ன செய்ய முடியும் லிக்விடேட் பண்ணுறது அப்படின்னா ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ண முடியும் And contingent function like it is basis of the credit system. That is both in the business transaction, either in the cash or on credit. This you can study in your accountancy classes. Commerce accountancy la padichirpinga illaya? So the basic credit system, business transaction illa cash avo, check avo, kudukranga, vekkranga appadina adellame money udaya format da. For example. Depositor can make use of checks only when there are sufficient funds in his account. If now our business manager, I am going to give the check for the purchase. Now, raw material, for now, I will check to put it. I have to keep a fund in my account. Now, in the bank, to check to put it. Now, the bank will make a decision. For man, our fund is not enough. I can use check. So, the basic credit system. Money is main thing. It has to be deposited. It has to be there in the bank. And money is the back of all credit. Ellathukkum backbone a irukkuradhu, main a irukkuradhu money da. So for example, the business people, they used to do that. In the week, things vaangittu povanga, next week, kodandhu money kudupanga. That is credit system. So based on their ability, they will give you, the business people, they will give the goods and other things. Adutthadhu. Money facilitates distribution of national income. So, distribution of national income was exceedingly complex under the barter system. So, barter system arthumbodhu national income eppadi pirichu kudukkuradhu abingiradhu theriyadhu. Ena only they have only goods in their hands. They did not have money. So, barter system it is very complicated to distribute their wealth and asset. But at the same time, now we are having money. If you have listened to the budget of this year, you can easily understand. Nammudaiya national income, I already told you, contribution from the three main sectors. Primary sector agricultural, secondary sector industry, and service sector. The territory sector of that service sector. So the contribution has been given by all the three sectors. So the national income which they have collected, it is easily to allocate the fund to each sector. And also in the form of rent, wage, interest, ellame eppadi dhaan podu in the form of money. And also money helps to equalize marginal utilities and marginal productivities. So the consumer, he can obtain maximum utility only if he incurs expenditure on various commodities in such a manner as to equalize marginal utility occurring for them. This you have studied in 11th standard, illaya? Utility la padikkum bodhu equi marginal utility. Law of marginal utility padichirukkar. Consumer can attain the utility when he has spent his amount. Now, it is in equalizing these marginal utilities, money plays an important role because prices of all commodities equalized expressed in money. The equi marginal utility onnu padichinga. Have you remembered this? In the 11th standard. So the income has been distributed to two things. One is to apple, the other is to oranges. And you remember the cost of apple and orange is 1. When he consumed 6 apples and 4 oranges, he will get his marginal utility, say 4 kilometers. Have you remember? So the utility and the other things can be measured only if he purchased the goods in the terms of money. Do you understand? So now equalizing this marginal utilities, money plays important role because the commodities are expressed in the terms of money. Apple and oranges are money format. Or apple, 6 rupees he is spending.
four oranges. So totally he has 11 rupees in his hands. So our 6 apples and 5 oranges vaangum bodhu he will get maximum utility of 4 appdinu varum. 1 rupee each cost 1 rupee appdinu varum. So in the terms of money we are expressing. So these are the functions of money: primary, secondary, other and contingent function. Primary we have two functions: medium of exchange and the measure of value. In the medium of exchange we have two sides, one is sales, the other one is purchase. And also the measure of value we have studied, and the store of value, it is easy to store. Instead of goods we can store money easily. And standard of deferred payment, for repaying the credit and other things, it is easy to repay in the terms of money, we have studied. And the contingent functions, basis of credit facility, distribution of national income, and productivity, marginal utility and productivity. And also we studied the equalized marginal productivity and increases the productivity. And the last one, other functions, liquid and also easy for repayment, generalized purchasing power. So with this, the functions of money has been is over. In the next class we will see, in the next video we will see what is supply of money and what is the famous Irving Fisher's quantity theory of money. Thank you girls.